Hi guys, welcome to another video by Best Lathe Plans. Today we're looking at a magnetic stand. There's a bit of a loose thread between the actual magnetic base and the arm. So today we're evaluating what the problem is and how we can fix it. Here you can see the base actually wobbling against the arm here, and the screw thread on the arm actually protrudes into the base too far. So it actually prevents the magnet inside the base from rotating. We're going to test the threads here with an M5 die. And as you can see, the steel threads on the arm are actually in very good condition. You do have to be a bit careful when doing this because you don't want to damage the threads any further with the die as well. So just take a little bit of care when screwing it on and screwing it off. So we're happy with the threads on the arm. The next step is to look at the threads on the magnetic base. So from a visual inspection, you can actually see that these threads are very, very worn and they're not actually very thick at all. Because the threads are so worn, we can't actually use an M5 tap to re-thread with the same size. So we're actually going to have to re-drill the hole and use a larger tap. Here you can see me removing the small vinyl cover, which just indicates on and off for the switch. The reason for doing this is because the screws are actually hidden behind the cover to allow you to remove the magnet from the base. Okay, now the cover is removed, you can actually see the two screws which hold the magnet and the switch in place. We'll grab a screwdriver and we'll whip these two screws out, and then we can remove the magnet. It's actually becoming quite apparent that this magnetic base is actually quite cheaply manufactured. These two screws as well are quite loosely fitting. Because they're not actually that crucial to the operation of the magnetic base, we're not going to bother fixing them, we're going to leave them as is. Okay, so now we have the cover removed from the magnetic base, and you can see that the switch is actually just a very, very simple plastic form which just sits in a groove within the magnet. The magnet here was really quite difficult to get out of the base. The two were attracting each other quite strongly, so it took a bit of effort to get them out. So the most difficult part was being able to get enough grip on the magnet. I didn't want to use pliers because I was worried I actually might damage the magnet, so I ended up just doing it by hand. With the magnet removed, I tested it with a tap, and you can actually see here really how strong the magnet is. Okay, so with the magnet removed, I could evaluate the threads on the base, and they really, really were quite worn. So here I'm just showing the drill size for a standard M7 by 1.0mm pitch tap, and as you can see, it's 6mm. So the drilling was very straightforward, as was the tapping. As mentioned, this is a very cheap magnetic stand, so the material was very soft. And there we have it. That's the finished magnetic base. All that's left to do now is to make a small adapter to go from the M7 to the M5 thread, which we'll do out of brass on the lathe. The only other thing to do is just check the thickness of the top of the magnetic stand so that the threaded section of the adapter is the correct length. Okay, so for the lathe work, we're going to use some brass hex bar. The stock I've got here is 1/2 inch, that's 12.7mm, and it was just what I had available at the time. The stock was mounted in the 3-jaw chuck, we changed the lathe tool, and we reduced the end diameter down to 7mm, ready to be threaded using the M7 die. As you can see, the end of the thread was chamfered just to make it a bit neater, and then it was tested in the magnetic base. Once I was happy, it was then marked and parted off. It was then flipped around in the chuck and we cleaned up the other end and drilled it and tapped it M5. Once I finished all the machining, I checked the part over and then it was back to the workbench for reassembly. I applied some Loctite 270 to the adapter, added a washer and then threaded it into the base. I then reassembled the magnetic base. I used some of the slightly weaker Loctite 243 on the arm and threaded that into the adapter. After a small amount of work, the repair went really quite well. As you can see, there's absolutely no play between the base and the arm. And so that brings us to the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, and if you'd like to see more, I'd really appreciate your subscription. Stay safe, and I'll see you soon.